How are you? I'm just removing a mask. Hopefully everyone will keep the mask on. For the sake of, yes, because the city, and I have received so many emails from the city now that we should keep the control by any time. Anyway, today this is not the khatra. The khatra, subhanAllah, about a debate happened between me and my daughter. The khatra is saying that my daughter came one day and said, I don't have any control in my life. I don't know what I'm going to do now, tomorrow. The way we live, and so many things. And I told her a story about me. The story I want to share with everyone, one of the brothers here is sitting, he knows it. But anyway, this happened on 2012. In 2012, I prayed to Allah to make me from the people who build a mosque. And I was praying, and I did my hard thing. And subhanAllah, one of my brothers came to me and said, don't worry. Try, but don't worry. And I looked at him, I said, oh, it's so far. How can I be? We build a mosque, $3 million, $2 million, $400. Come on, I cannot afford it even. I'm thinking limited from my head. And subhanAllah, when it happened in March of 2013, we should have received the mosque before Good Friday. It's Good Friday. And technicality, I was taking care of the insurance. And a problem happened. And they delayed the opening. I was crying. Literally, I was crying from my eyes that Allah doesn't want me to do my what I dreamed of. And subhanAllah, with that, my brother came to talk to me. I said, don't worry. Allah has a plan. You do your job, and he'll do his. Take care of that part. Don't worry about it. And subhanAllah, when we came on Tuesday, on Monday here, we prayed with a brother here and do the adhan. At that time, there was wine. There is bottles of wine here. We start clearing the place. If you open on Thursday, really, we couldn't open because there was wine. It's dirty here. The place wasn't that good. Why I'm going that way? Again, the discussion, remember, between me and my daughter, what will happen tomorrow? The discussion is, aqilha wa tawakkal. One man came to the Prophet and talked to him about his camel. Should I leave it? Or should I tie it and atawakkal Allah? Two approaches. Aqilha, you have to do your part. You have to do your job. The body will work. And you make the dua. If you think of, especially the old people over 25 like me, if you talk to them before they come to Canada here, and tell me about it that you're thinking to come to Canada. I believe I came in 97. If someone tells me in 94 or 93, you're coming to Canada? No. And why should I come to Canada? I'm living with my family. Everything is fine. But I was praying to Allah to make me from a people to make da'wah. Somehow. I don't know how. Let's take an example, a better example than me. Because definitely he's a better example than me. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Come on. Alayhi salatu wasalam. We hear our Prophet. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Remember, Allah will remember you for, I will tell you 10 times. Alayhi salatu wasalam, before he was a prophet, he did his part. He was trustworthy. He's Sadiq al-Amin. He's taking care of everything around him. He's doing his job in his life. And Allah has a plan for every one of us. Then what should we do? The Prophet ﷺ was trying, seeing the idols, he couldn't do anything. But he doesn't like it. Doesn't like it. And the prophecy came in to change the world, change the life. His dua made the change. But Allah has a plan for everyone. What's our role? For everyone. Every one of us has a role in life. Your role is to act and make dua. Make dua to Allah with everything in life. Istikhara lillah. Make dua, pray to Allah. In what? In sujood. Make, oh Allah, guide me, help me. I want to do this. I don't know if it's true or not. The ulama said, if I pray to Allah to do something, if Allah gives me, I'm happy. If Allah doesn't give me, I'll be more happier. Because He knows better. He knows better. What should I do? If I stayed back home, I don't know what we're gonna do. I will definitely will not see these beautiful faces. Definitely. If I stay back home. Any of us, tell me if you're gonna stay back home, you'll see me. You'll be happy. But anyway, if you see me, if you see others, the good brothers around you. Okay? That's the way it is in life. Allah has plans for every one of us. What are you gonna do? فَأَعْقِلْهَا وَتَوَكَّلْ. How can you teach your youth, young youth, how to dream? It's a good to dream, but how to work on that dream? By act, learn knowledge, and raising your 10 fingers to Allah to make dua, to make da'wah. To Allah, oh Allah, I want to marry, I want to be rich. If you see the rich is good to me, give it to me. If not, make me happy with whatever you give me. And أقدر للخير حيث كان. This is, we need to work on that part. So many times in our lives, hard, we doubt that part. We doubt it, really, we doubt it. Why Allah is doing that to me? Why? And you see, especially the youth are going that path. Why Allah is putting me in this catastrophe? Why my father died? Why I failed? Why I did this? Why I did that? Teach them and teach yourself. Respond. Allah has a plan. Work with it and accept it. I'll finish with a hadith. The meaning of the hadith. If you accept what Allah is giving to you, and accept you will be rewarded. And قدر الله ماضٍ. Allah, his writing will see it. And if you disagree, you will be penalized. And قدر الله ماضٍ. And Allah will play, his plans will stay. I hope this is the khatira of today. Come out, learn how to tawakkal Allah حق توكل. Remember to make dua as much as you can in every part of our lives. The Prophet told the Sahaba to do istikhara in every part of their lives. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر لكم جزاكم الله خير. Brothers, remember, please keep the mask on. Now our neighbors are closed. And the plan, I don't know, we're looking to with the city. Hopefully they will not close us soon, but we'll see. We'll keep on you updated. Keep following, inshallah. May Allah bless all of us. Jazakum Allah khair.